this situation, Pat, where the water's been over this pump for, or possibly at the longest period, it was probably underwater for at least 12 days. What's the best things to look for? The first thing I'd do is obviously clear the debris, and then your telescopic slide shaft there, and give that a grease, even though they're greased every day, but it's been underwater for a long time. Your rubber coupling, I mean, whether there's crap in that, whether it needs to be cleared, and then obviously all your bearings inside your pump here.
No, that's for sure, Nathan. The debris that you can see, obviously, but some of the things that you can't see are like sediment inside these tyres, which can not wear anything out immediately, but it sends the balance of the shaft could be put out of balance quite a bit, and that'll load up these bearings, and also it gets magnified into the back of the engine. So particularly with high speed engines, this one's wouldn't be running at high speed, but quite often with high speed engines, the torsional vibration that goes into that flywheel can damage the crankshaft. So there's a lot of damage can be done just simply from sediment inside that tyre. They're not an easy thing to pull apart and check, but it's well worthwhile trying to clean it out. The other areas are that, as you stated, you'd grease all this. Well, this is a good idea. You probably give it a little more grease just to see whether any water droplets come out of the bearings, and because if there's any water in there, that'll the temperature when you get the pump going, the temperature rises fairly quickly, and that's what does the damage to the bearings. So
good idea for this time to possibly use high temperature grease instead of general purpose grease.
I'd probably go for high temperature grease because it's a little bit higher density as well. So it's going to take up some of those water droplets out of there. The other areas is any seals, just to make sure that the debris is completely clear from the seals. And even the telescopic shaft that you mentioned, whilst that's not a high moving part, you will get wear in there if there's sediment sitting in on the telescopic shaft. As far as the pump itself goes, any of these pumps that have got a packing gland, which is, that's really the way that you seal in the air out of the pump, so you can prime the pump and keep the prime. Well, inside there is gland packing, as you would have seen. If you get deposits of sediment in there and you're running it, it'll grind away at the main shaft. So it's a good idea just to, you know, back those nuts off a bit and get an air compressor and blow around the gland packing and just do them back up again as normal. In case you're not sure with that, when you do up gland packing, you should have about 5 drips a minute is what you need. You don't want to stop the water coming out because it'll burn the shaft and the packing. The bearings here, once again, you'd grease those and look for any signs of water bubbles coming out through the seals, because the seals are not good enough to keep the water in there, so the grease pressure will push that water out. And if you do see a lot of water in there, that's when you probably look at pulling it apart. But certainly look for the signs of water first. And that's the same with this counter shaft bearing here, of course. Grease it and just observe whether any water bubbles come out. Moving away from some of this moving stuff, though, the other things that I do, you know, at your water source, that might have changed down there. So next time you go to pump, you know, you don't want to be putting a heap of sand and stuff up through the system, so you probably want to make sure that you've still got a pumping hole there. And on the discharge here, we've got a air valve there on the non-return valve chamber there, Well, you just make sure that nothing's, you know, built up inside of things like that. But other than that, it would be good to go.